Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in the Cube. And I recently had a call with a customer and they asked something really interesting. They were like, hey Patrick, can we have a little notification show on our report when we make visual changes or DAX changes or add buttons and navigation? And I thought for a second and boom, a little light bulb went off. And that's what I'm gonna show you in this video. Stay tuned. If this is your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. Okay, so notifications. Someone asked me about notifications and they're like, look, we make a lot of changes to lots of pages in our report and we want to kind of notify the users of these changes when they open the report to the landing page of the report. And I was like, I don't think there's a native way to do that in Power BI, but I had an idea. And in this video, I'm actually gonna show you how I helped them solve that problem. All right, so enough of all this talking. You guys know what I like to do. Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. Let's say you created this report. And what they wanted to do was they wanted to add a blank page and then insert a text box and then write the notification, change the color, added a new measure. And I thought to myself, whew, man, that's gonna require a lot of maintenance because every time they make this change, they gotta republish the report. Then if they have an app, they gotta update the app. So that's not very efficient. And you guys know how I do. I'm not lazy, I'm just really efficient. And the first thing I said was, let's make this data driven. They think, oh, that's a great idea. But then I took it to the next level. To make it data driven, the first thing I did was delete that page, right? To make it data driven, you have to have a data entry tool. And I'm gonna channel my inner Marco. And I remember Marco Russo said this. He's like, the best data entry tool is what? It's Excel. And so I said, you can use other things. You can use Power Apps, you can use SharePoint lists, you can use all these different things, but why not use Excel? Because it's a great data entry tool. And I said, let's just enter the changes, you know, the things that you want to notify them about in a spreadsheet. And so I created four simple columns, one that says the date of the change. We're going to use this next column show to determine if we show it in the list of changes, the list of notifications, and in the description of the change, and then the report page. Okay, so that was the first thing we did, and I saved it. You can save it locally, you save it out on OneDrive, wherever you want to save it. Then I went over to the data model and I imported the CSV file. And what I did was, for that particular CSV file, I did a filter to only bring in the ones that had a one as the show. And you can change this and get very creative with this. And the reason I'm showing you this video, because, well, one of the reasons is it's the art of the possible. Think, imagine the things that you can do with Power BI. And this is one of the things where I just kind of got a little creative. After I imported the table, I created a new page and I dropped a few columns into a table. So right now it's empty because if you look at my spreadsheet, my CSV file, I don't have any of the rows set to show. And then what I did was I went to the landing page and I created a button. I did some special things with this button. The first thing I did was I created a measure that is gonna show me if I have any notifications. Now I put a threshold here for only show me notifications that are, you know, less than or equal to 2 days old. You can change this threshold to whatever you want. You can come up with your own filter. And that's basically gonna give me, you know, the number of notifications that we want to present to my report consumer. And then what I did was I created some navigation. Some of you may already be guessing, oh, this is conditional nav. And this is absolutely conditional nav that I'm using here. And so if you don't know what conditional nav is, you don't know how to configure it, go watch the videos. I did a couple of videos on it. That's another like obsession I have is conditional navigation. You go check it out. So I added this measure right here. This is going to determine where I navigate to. If there are any notifications, go to the notifications page and you can see that text matches the name of that page because that's where I'm going to list the notifications at. And then I created another measure that's going to determine the text that's shown on my conditional navigation button right here. So if there are notifications, say notifications and then wrap the number of notifications in parentheses. And then I also created one more measure that's going to control the background of my button with a field. And so once I did that, I configured conditional nav. So I added the button to the page, then I went to action, and then under action for destination, instead of hard coding it, so I'm going to delete this. So instead of, you know, choosing a specific page, I made it conditional. You click the conditional, the little FX button here, choose field value, and then go find that field. So I go to my notifications page and go to my measures and then find the notification navigation, okay? So that's going to determine if I navigate somewhere. And then what I did was I went to the button text and I did the same thing. I went here, but this time I chose notification text. And then I went to the fill option and then I used the notification fill, right? So I got it all set up. And so now if anything meets that condition where there are notifications greater than zero, something should happen to the button on my page. And so let's go over to back to my CSV file. I'm just gonna mark a couple of these to one. And there within the last 2 days, go ahead and save. And then I'm gonna just refresh the data for that table and watch what's gonna happen to that button. Boom, bam, I have two notifications. If I hold down control, because I'm in the desktop, and click it, it's gonna take me over to the page and list out the notifications for me. I added another little column here. If I click this, it'll bring me to the actual page. The way I did that was I added a calculated column that's just using some information from the spreadsheet, right, the report page, and I concatenated it to the actual URL of the report. And now if I click one of these, it's just gonna open up Power BI to that specific page, and then you can see the new waterfall chart that was added to the report. If this is deployed out to Power BI, right, the same thing, the notification will be here. I click over, I can see my list. If I click the back button, I go back to the landing page. What do you guys think? You know, have you run across something like this before? Have you run into any challenges like this? I showed this to Adam, he was like, can you think of the things we can do with this? If we use Power Automate and we can say, when you update the spreadsheet, send some emails out. I talked to Miguel Myers. Miguel is like this insane visualization expert. I talked to Chris Hamill, another insane visualization expert, and they were dropping all these different things that I can do and my mind was blown. All right, what do you guys think? Any questions, comments? You know what to do. Post them in the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, give me a big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching and we'll see you in the next video.